And it was surprising how I didn't look too ridiculous with like funky colored hair. But I think I'm gonna keep it low key if I do end up doing something with. Why do I say that? If I end up doing something with color, I don't want to go too crazy. I think the craziest I would go is red, but that's such a commitment, and I don't think that would be the smartest choice for right now. Even so, I do enjoy her hair color. That's very pretty, and it wouldn't be too off the mark from what I have. There's anything wrong with gray hair, but if you have it, but if you don't, it's kind of, I think you really have to have the right features to pull it off, just like any color, really, you know, because I've seen it where it doesn't look amazing, and I've seen it where it looks okay, you know. Anyways, feminine crops, retro ponytails, with the bump up, That's cruel. I can't do that. I'd love to, though. That's not for me, no. That's interesting. It's just blown forward, though. I wonder what that was like. This looks really cute. Looks cute. This is cute too. I like that. Actually, let's see. I think I'm just gonna fold the page. Magical mid-length, not too long, not too short. This length will give you the best of both styling worlds. This is look, it looks like a shag, but like a modern shag, sort of, because it's thin at the bottom, thin and wispy at the bottom, thin layers, but then there's like heavy up here. Thank you. edge shorter. I don't think that would work though. Again with the bangs. Daunting. Slur. Find your perfect part. This is cool. That is a cool look. Look at that. It's so neat. I wish I could go for something cool like that. Just different, but it's such a commitment. And again, it's kind of gray. Oh.